Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today I'll show you how I make Sheera or rava kesari, as it is known as in my hometown. So let's get started. These are the ingredients. I've taken half cup of sugar. In Bombay we get huge sugar, cubes of sugar. 1 cup of Sooji, this is the fine Sooji. 1/2 cup of clarified butter, that is ghee. Nuts as per taste. I have taken cashew and kismis. I will fry the cashews in ghee but not the kismis. Fry it till it is golden brown. Use 1 teaspoon of ghee from the same 1/2 cup. Fry well till it is golden brown. You can use almonds also. See that you don't burn the nuts. I have broken the cashews into pieces. If you like, you can keep it whole. Once they are golden brown, keep it aside and in the same pan fry the rava or suji, whatever we call. Add another 2 teaspoons of ghee and fry the suji till you get a good aroma and the suji is roasted well. Don't brown it, otherwise the color will change. It is on a slow flame. It takes around 2 to 3 minutes. Keep stirring because suji tends to burn very fast and the color changes to dark brown. Once it is done, keep it aside in a plate. In the same pan, add 2 cups of water and let the water come to a boil. If you have taken 1 cup of suji, you take 2 cups of water. Let it boil. When the water is boiling, add in a little bit of salt. You know, salt brings in the taste of the sweet dish. For all the sweet dishes, I do add a little salt. This is milk with food color and elachi powder. I've taken around 4 teaspoons of milk. I've taken yellow food color. You can use the orange one. Once the water boils, add in the fried and roasted rava. Keep stirring so that the rava doesn't form lumps. It usually forms lump, but break it. Keep breaking it when you are stirring it. And cook till the water is absorbed. By then the suji will increase in volume. Keep stirring. See that it's on a slow flame. Now it's almost dried up and water has evaporated. Keep mixing. At this point of time, you can add in the sugar. Like I said, the sugar cubes in Bombay are very huge, unlike in the Gulf. Once you add the sugar, and when the sugar starts melting, again it will turn watery. Keep mixing till it gets dry mix well, see that there are no lumps. Add in the remaining ghee. And keep mixing slowly. At this point of time, you may feel it is too much of ghee, but when it is done, it will be perfect. Keep on stirring. If you like your sweets to be very sweet, you can increase the quantity of sugar to around 3/4 cup. Add in the milk with the food color and elachi powder. Elachi powder or cardamom powder depends upon you. I have added around 1/4 teaspoon. Mix well. When I was trying to mix, I realized the color is a bit less and I wanted to add a little more. To get the yellowish color in the final dish. So I added a little more of the color, but don't add too much, otherwise it will look too yellowish. Mix well. By the time the dish would start leaving the side of the pan and the ghee is well incorporated. Once it is mixed thoroughly, you can add in the fried nuts. Mix well and your dish is ready. I hope you like this recipe of mine. Do give it a try. I'm sure you will enjoy it. Thank you all for watching. Please do subscribe to my channel and click the like button. See you soon next time with a new recipe. The list of ingredients is given in the description box. Bye till then.